It's just round after round after round, and these guys are absolutely beating the out of each other. It's like a street fight, and neither one of these guys is gonna ever give up.
All right, girls, you ready? Cam, you gotta win this one to stay in the game. You girls ready?
Now I'm starting to see the relationship that Cam and I have in the house is kind of weird. She's the only girl that's in my alliance. We've never even spoken game. I think it's just obvious that she's my number one and I'm her number one.
As an assassin. That's just all I'm here to do. I'm not here to win any money. I'm just here to with everyone else's game.
Hold up. Killer Cam is out now. I'm ready.
Cam, body her.
Girl, you better give it, because I ain't gonna give up.
All right, girls, the score is 1-0 Tori. Cam, you gotta win this one to stay in the game. Girls, ready? Go!
Can go either way now. Whoever wants it the most, they ain't gonna send me home on my first elimination.
Whew. Girls, ready? Next point wins. Girls, ready? Go!
Y'all ain't sending me home. Ain't nobody was sending me home on my first elimination. Mm-mm.
It's your ex, Nani. It's yours!
This is what Nani's been asking for as long as I can remember, to get her hands on Teresa. So get your popcorn ready, because this is gonna be a dogfight.
All right, Teresa and Nani. Teresa, you guys got a 1-point lead. You win this, you go straight to the finals. Nani, you need this point to stay alive.
With this elimination, anything goes, and I'm going for it. I just want to toss this girl around because she's my worst enemy, and I need to win this.
Are you ready?
You got this, Nani? How you feel, Nani?
Yeah, Nani!
Nani takes Teresa and just hip checks her. And Teresa hits the ground so hard, I actually feel the ground shake.
There you go, roll over, Teresa. Once you get it on your stomach, there you go, Teresa.
There you go, Nani.
Get your whole body on it, Teresa.
And a girl,
keep your body weight on her.
Pull, Nani. Lean back, Nani. Pull hard, Nani.
Hold on, Teresa.
You're rolling towards your head, Nani.
I can feel how much energy she's really putting into this, and sooner or later, I know she's just gonna kind of gas out.
There you go, Teresa. Fight.
You taking me?
No, I'm not kicking.
You're not kicking me? All right.
There you go, fight. Keep forcing that knee down. Yeah.
Sure. Got her foot on her face.
I don't care that I'm kicking her in her face. Hopefully knock out a tooth or something. Sorry, not sorry.
Relax.
She's biting me. You got your knee in my face, bitch.
There you go, Teresa.
These girls are doing every dirty move in the book, kicking each other in the face, and it's really tough to see who has got the upper hand.
Take it. That's yours. You got it, Teresa. You got one hand on it.
Let it go, Nani. There you go. Just like that. Pull
top of it. How bad do you want this final? Fight, fight, baby.
There you go. Get your knee on her hand.
There you go.
You got this, Nani.
Yes.
You're in the final.
Yeah.
You're in the final, baby. Payday.
Yeah.
Payday.
Pulling this axe away from Nani wraps everything up into a giant present. To beat them and make it to a final, this is epic for me.
All right, girls, you ready? Susie ready? Kimberly ready?
Ruins really sucks, but I really want $30,000 in my personal bank account, so I'm just gonna hold on for dear life. It's really brutal and exhausting. I'm really surprised how difficult it is to pull the rope out of Kimberly's hands.
It's a new identity.
Watching Kim and Susie go at it is quite impressive. They're working very hard. They're tired. They're bleeding. This is a hard one.
Keep doing that. She's out of rope. Keep that arm in there, Susie. Go! Go!
Who was it?
I don't know.
That was close.
I'm nervous because they both hit the bell, it seems like, at the same time.
All right, boys. Marlon and Jordan won that first round. So Marlon and Jordan, one more, and you guys win. Leroy and Ty, you guys have to win to stay in the game.
There's no way that I'm gonna just let Marlon overpower me like this. Division I football player or not.
Let's finish it, let's finish it.
I'm pretty sure that Jordan and Marlon have this in the bag. I'd be shocked if Leroy and Ty pull anything out of their ass.
You guys ready?
I don't know what happened. Who set a flame on the Leroy and Ty's ass, but Ty looks like he gets shot out of a cane.
Ty, get it, Ty!
Go, go,
get it, Ty!
Go, go.
Watching Ty and Leroy push back Jordan and Marlon is awesome. It's one step closer to getting this arrogant little out of the house.
This jungle is so nerve-wracking. I want to turn around right now, and I want Nani to just tell me when it's over.
All right, boys, the score is 1-1. Next point wins.
I've never been more nervous in my entire life. This third round, it's a toss-up.
Ready?
Nasty, nothing gets past me. Me and my boy working, sweating like some athletes. Check your fact sheet, then check the last heat. This is past heat, then we kill them when they trap me.
Ty is right next to the bell. Leroy's got Jordan pinned. It's like, oh my God, what's gonna happen?
Ty's literally 3 feet from the bell. We're sitting here thinking at any moment he's gonna break free and ring this bell.
Going into our first elimination round and winning is just, we're on cloud nine, yo.
Let's go, baby.
We competed and we won. Like, that's the best feeling ever.
Siobhan ready? Nisa ready? Go!
I go bananas, and I am ready to essentially, like, fight this girl.
I really don't know what's going on. All I know is that I see two hooks laying on the ground and Anissa and the boob girl just duking it out, not even going for rings.
You're choking me! What the f***?
You gotta go for the hook!
Next time.
No, I didn't.
Don't push me in my face.
Don't choke me.
Nisa, one more. You win. Siobhan, you need to pick it up.
You know what to do, ladies. You gotta get in there and get it. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I like it.
You gotta go after her. Go after her. Go hitting.
Right now, we're not even wrestling to win these rings. She's swinging her fist at me. I'm kicking her. We're literally brutally fighting.
No hitting. Ah! No punching. You gotta go for her hook, Siobhan.
Take it.
Joss has no idea the hell that's about to be brought upon him tonight in this ring.
I don't know who any of these people are. I don't give a Derek, he looks like a little squirrel. I'm gonna put this guy through his paces.
Well, it feels awesome to be back, as always. I didn't think I'd be here as a mercenary. So now I gotta fight off the challenge bull. I've never seen him before. I have no idea who he is. I'm gonna do all the guys up here a favor and beat the out of Joss.
All right, Joss, Derek, you guys ready?
I think getting rid of Joss is gonna do everyone a favor in this game. I mean, we've seen the guy run up the Rock of Gibraltar without taking a breath. So he is gonna be a huge roadblock for all the guys in this game.
Reset.
I think Derek might have met his match. I see a future vendetta. These two will either become best friends after this or never talk to each other again.
All right, guys, you ready?
Is seriously the most intense elimination I have ever seen. It's hard to watch, but it's hard to keep your eyes off. Someone could get hurt. Someone could die. Like, this is no joke right now.
Let's go, get the hands on there. Let's go, boys. All right, boys, you ready?
Look at me number one, and I say it proudly. I don't give a what, all of y'all gon' give it up. Hit you with a truck, they gon' have to come and scrape you up.
I don't think Joss was expecting this. The fight that I've seen from Derek, this guy has zero quit. Ever. This is the hardest fought battle I have ever seen in an elimination.
I've never met such an angry little person in my life. He is the most stubborn little Rottweiler, but I'm here to win, so I've got this.
Turn him over!
like an hour. And I mean, these warriors are just not willing to give up.
You guys, this battle is way too good. I haven't seen somebody this evenly matched in a long time. So, we're gonna hang that eight. It's gonna be sudden death. First point wins. It all comes down to this. You guys ready?
Both these guys are just absolute titans. Neither one will quit. I think they're both in a tremendous amount of pain, and I actually start to feel bad that I voted Joss into this. And if he wins, I'm gonna be in a bad spot. So I'm just hoping that he doesn't come back.
Come on, Joss!
Because you went out of bounds, you'll need to reset in the center of the ring.
Joss, you got this! Joss, let's go!
You guys ready?
Let's go, Joss!
It's just round after round after round, and these guys are absolutely beating the out of each other. It's like a street fight, and neither one of these guys is gonna ever give up.
Stop, let's go!
All right, guys, you ready?
Joss actually thinks it's over, but what he's done is he's left the ring and thought that Derek left the ring as well when he hasn't. So Joss is f***ed up here.
That's it.
It was my bad, I lost. I thought we weren't out the ring. I let go, he scored. But you know what? He put up a good fight, and so did I. So I went out with a bang.
Derek, you're a monster.
Today's challenge is called Backstabber. And no, you guys are not playing down here on the sand. You're playing 600 feet in the air on the top of that building.
Yeah.
Simple challenge, guys. All you gotta do is walk the plank.
Sorry, guys, you're not having a beach day, but you can walk across that building up there that's 600 feet tall. And I'm like, no.
See those three balance beams at the very top? Those balance beams are what you guys are gonna be walking on. There are three X's at the end of every beam. The left X is for the person on the left beam. The middle X is for the one in the middle. The right is for the right. The first person out there will slap an X of their choosing. Drop someone from the sky.
There's two types of people in this world. There's people who say they like heights, and there's f***ing liars.
I am totally terrified to be up here. So what I'm hoping is that either Derek or Jordan can set the fastest time on this. I've already promised both of them allegiance, so it's pretty close to a certainty that neither Jordan nor Derek is gonna drop me.
I like heights. We got a great view, so that's a plus. You know, we got these butterflies going, let you know you're alive. This is what you do the challenge for. This is what you come for.
I need to win bad. I mean, there's a lot on the line right now. The power, the control of this game lies right here.
All right, Bananas, Jordan, Derek, you ready?
Got it.
I'm coming for you, D. Dude, it was the closest one. I'm coming for you. I don't know what the got. My whole life just flashed before my eyes, dude.
I love you, man. I love you.
Am I doing your dirty work? What's going on here?
As you can see, there's a giant wall with a bunch of holes in it suspended over the water. And there are two bars through those holes. To begin, all four players are going to get on that platform. Two players on one side of the wall, two players on the other. Your goal is to make it from one platform to the other using only those two bars as a walkway. All right, guys, you ready?
That's good, yeah. That's perfect. Thanks, Isaac.
Knowing that I could possibly fall is the scariest thing ever. You're nervous and the wind's blowing and the crane is shaking and everybody's looking. That is nerve-wracking.
A little more, maybe a little more. Leroy's got big ass feet.
Here we go, Isaac.
I'm looking down at the water, or trying not to, and the wind starts blowing, and all I can think of is hang on for dear life.
Nice job. All right, we're getting out. Here we go, here we go. Let me know when you guys are on.
We're good.
Woohoo!
I hate it. I'm not big on talking a big game and being cocky. I hate it. I hate the sense of entitlement she has.
How's that?
Now's the time for you to forget about all of your bad blood, because today you're gonna need a lot of communication and trust. Today you're playing Give Me Some Slack. As you can see, there's a giant apparatus out here suspended 400 feet over the crashing waves. There are also some skulls hanging off the side. Your goal is to retrieve as many skulls as you can as fast as possible. Nicole and Dario, you ready? Go!
Okay, go ahead, I got you, Dario, I got you.
Dario, you're fooling me, okay. Les, God.
Go ahead. She's yelling at me, I'm yelling at her. We're like 2 minutes into this thing, and we're already yelling at each other.
I got you,
don't worry. Let's go, move on, here we go, come on.
Come on, it's about speed. It's a race, let's go.
All right, ready, I got you. Let me know, more or less?
Less, pull it a little tight.
I got you.
A little slack.
Yeah, I got you, with those long fingers, baby, let's go.
Okay, a little,
let's go, Nicole.
There you go, good job, Nicole. Okay, out, tighten it. My stomach is just doing flips and flops and turns. I'm staring straight down at the ground. If Jesus wanted me to fall from the sky, he would have given me wings.
Okay, a little.
Good, Jess.
Okay, back. Johnny, back.
Come on. You gotta lean with me, Jesse. You gotta lean with me.
Good job. Nicole.
You're good, Jess.
Let's go.
Wait.
Let's go.
My pace. Dario pulls way too hard for my weight, and when he's yanking, I feel like I'm gonna fall, so I have to just yell at him any which way so he understands that if he pulls me off of this, we're done.
All right, here we go.
Pull it a little tight.
Yeah, I got you,
tight.
I got you, don't
tight.
Worry.
Tight.
There you go, Nicole. Okay, a little. I'm leaning.
I don't hear his voice. I don't hear anything encouraging coming out of his mouth. I don't think he has any faith in me whatsoever.
Lean.
Yeah.
Lean. Okay. Back.
That's a scary. Riley is pissed.
Well, I got the skull. You die.
The term epic is overused a bit, but this is epic, guys. Today, you guys are gonna be playing Skybridge. Now, you're definitely gonna have to mend some fences today as you repair a rope bridge 1,000 feet above Hermanus.
But I think we should move together, right?
Sure.
Because then it'll be more tension or no?
I don't know. I think I should get down there and then you should pump.
Okay. I'm gonna be a scared little.
Zach and Amanda, Joss and Sylvia, you guys ready?
Hey, guys. Come on, babe. A little bit more, so. A little bit more.
All right, Amanda, come on.
I'm coming.
Reach out and get it around that thing. All right. Man, that's not too tight, huh? You gotta wrap it around more, babe.
I have to undo it to do that. I'm just gonna have to chill, bro.
Today's biggest challenge is convincing Amanda that she's not worthless. Let yours out.
I can't.
Amanda, you're gonna have to stop saying I can't.
Shut up.
We're flopping around like it's Joss's limp. Let yours out.
Joss never has a limp.
Oh,
bet you're not.
It's ridiculous. Just try.
Dude, look how loose that one is.
Chill the f*** out.
I can't.
Come on, Amanda.
Shut up, Zach.
If I would rather jump off a cliff than be Zach's partner, that has to tell you something.
Oh my gosh, you're killing me.
I'm feeling confident. I'm not afraid of the water. I need to do this for my team. Cam and Jemmy just blew it.
There is $500,000 at stake, and it is very important to win.
You got it, Murray!
I'm feeling confident. I gotta get this win today because I need to be in a striker, and I wanna get some money in my bank account.
In the water, face down. Not swimming, not moving. I'm freaking out right now.
His back, yo. He's all right.
I'm terrified, man. I mean, watching your best friend emerge out of the water, lifeless, it's absolutely terrifying.
I slip. How are you talking about it?
It just seems like a curse. Every season, it seems like something bad happens to Leroy. He might have really seriously injured himself, and I'm hoping that he's okay.
Get back. All right, everybody. Welcome to Panama City, Panama. This is your first challenge on Battle of the X's 2. You guessed it, we're in a big city with very big buildings. You guys are gonna be going from one of these tall buildings to the other on a tightrope that is suspended 500 feet in the air.
The challenge just comes up with new ways to just instill the fear of God in us. I love this stuff, man.
This is crazy. It's gonna come down to communication. Hopefully we can bring it together.
Our communication and our relationship was above average until the end, but when things were good, I thought we communicated very well.
Yeah, until you stopped talking to me.
Until I stopped talking to her, then they were really bad.
You ready?
Outside of the game, I do not trust Wes whatsoever, but when it comes to money in a competition, I'm his partner, so I have to trust him. Kind of relying on him right now to not drop me.
I'm really hoping that Teresa can knock this out fast because I need to be put back onto solid ground as soon as possible.
All right, Zach, Johnny, Teresa, Wes, you ready?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Zach, hold on.
John A looks like a baby deer on ice. Her knees are wobbling. She's swinging all around. This is pretty pathetic.
Good job. So good.
She's falling quite a bit. And at first, that's really scary because I'm spending a lot of time curling her back up. What is happening is every time she's falling, she's actually pulling me. She's falling in the right direction.
You're going, girl.
I can't pull you.
Zach is gigantic, and Jonna's arms are like toothpicks, so there's no way she's dragging him across that rope.
Nice job, Teresa.
Now I'm gonna pull him?
Zach, no, don't pull the rope. What are you doing?
I'm holding you up.
No, oh my God, no.
God damn it.
If this is any indication of how this Battle of the X's 2 is gonna go for me, it's not gonna be very good.
No. Little step, keep going.
This is definitely a hard challenge. Not only are you suspended in the air, but you're working with someone who you don't really get along with. I just feel a lot of pressure.
Am I there?
No.
Both feet!
Get in the circle.
I'm paired up with Kaylee for this swim, and I'm pretty confident we're not gonna be any trouble here. I know there's other people in the house which are worse swimmers than her, so all she needs to do is go faster than the slowest person.
Let's go, Kaylee! Kaylee is really, really struggling, and therefore my best friend is struggling. And he might be about to get cut.
You have to put me in front of the horn!
Come on, sprint!
We are still waiting for Kaylee to get back. I mean, I have never seen somebody swim with so little intensity. I'm like, dude, we're in a challenge. Like, let's go.
It's so hard to gauge who has come last, who is where, because everyone set off at different times. And we've just got to wait and pray we're not last.
The pair that swims the slowest is gone.
If I get sent home because of someone else's ability, because they can't swim, I'll be genuinely gutted.
It's Joss and Kaylee.
Oh my God.
I'm in shock. How are we as slow as Cam and Leroy? They can't swim.
All right, so take care, you guys.
We're still here, right? Sorry, Joss.
I'm feeling super disappointed. I've let Joss down and I unfortunately lost our place in the game, but the only thing I can do is get better at swimming and come back stronger.
Karma is a mother effing bitch because Georgia would have kicked everyone's butt in this swim. She would have crushed this, but you decided to protect Kaylee.
Joss, you let Kaylee talk into putting your own teammate in.
You f*** up! I trusted you. It's disgusting.
Joss, that's what you get. That's what you get for protecting somebody who can't perform.
I thought we were a lot faster than that.
Rogan, please bring this home. You're the last British standing in the whole game, and we've torn each other apart. All the best players on our team saw elimination. Theo, me, Jenny, Georgia, out of love to swim with Jenny or Georgia today.
You have a powerhouse of a team, Tony and Johnny Bananas, going up against the true underdog team of the season, Natalie and Polly. Tonight is going to be one epic elimination.
Okay. Yep.
For me to give us a shot, I got to eat everything on that table and just hope Polly taps out.
I would squirt milk in my eye straight out of a cow teat at this point for $1 million. So no, I'm not scared about the spilled milk. I'm scared about some tiny little vertically challenged Venezuelan holding their arms up for longer than me. That's what I'm scared of.
I'm just getting nervous.
It'll be all right. Just get your head in the game. Delicious milk and cookies.
Yes, yummy.
All I know is I'm going against the human garbage disposal known as Tony.
Don't think that I can hold my arms for that long, okay? You better eat those cookies and drink that milk so quick.
I'm a competitor. We're going against the best team here. Mm-hmm. I want to beat them just for that reason. I want to put that notch on my rookie belt.
Yep.
Okay, let's get you both.
All players on the platform, arms up.
Milk go bad in a fridge and opened it and smelled it. Now think about drinking that. It is the most disgusting thing I have ever put in my mouth.
The way they're drinking this, they have to glug it. You can see the chunks in this milk as they're eating it. This is revolting.
There you go, Tony. There you go, Tony. If you gotta vomit, make some room.
I gotta fill them up, huh?
In the final, I would love for Johnny and Tony to run it with us. I think they're deserving. And Tony has put on a few pounds, so he might not be the best person when it comes to endurance. And any kind of leg up that I could have on the competition, that would be beneficial.
This is gonna be all about you, Johnny.
Don't wanna live as an untold story.
I'm not watching Polly and Tony eat. I'm just staying zoned in, focused, and concentrated on not dropping my arms. I will stay up as long as I need to.
I wanna taste love and pain. Wanna feel pride and shame. I don't wanna take my time. I wanna live better, just
come out.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Wow. I feel so much better. This guy, Paulie, is also a psychopath. I'm impressed, dude. I didn't think you'd be able to hang with me, man, but you motherfuckers are going home. If I got anything to do about it, I'm never gonna stop.
Me neither.
You're never gonna stop.
Johnny!
I'm just trying to convince myself that whatever pain I'm in, Natalie is experiencing the exact same kind of pain. Although every time I look over at her, it looks like it's not even bothering her.
Hey, Paulie, you pissed if I go over there and tickle Natalie right now? Natalie, it's over. I got about like 20 cups. So stop torturing yourself.
Five.
Hearing Paulie throw up so much is surprisingly motivating me to keep my arms up because I don't want to let him down. We're both in extreme pain.
It's almost as if I can feel it in the air that tonight is mine and Natalie's night and we're punching our ticket to this final.
Natalie, it's on you, baby. All night, you got this. I'm finished.
Good job, Tony.
Guys, it's down to you two.
I'm caught in the middle of two teams that were the only two teams that I ever really had in this whole game. But Johnny and Tony would be a tough team in the final. So, kind of rooting on Natalie here.
All right, guys. Tony and Paulie have finished all the milk and cookies that we had in South Africa. So now it comes down to who can last longer, bananas or Natalie?
The pain begins to get unimaginable. It's not just my shoulders that are killing me. It's essentially my entire body.
This is all you, baby. Laser focus.
I'm not putting my money on anybody because bananas and Natalie look like actual statues. This is gonna be a long night.
This is incredible. We've got to be here for 2 hours at least.
Armageddon tired.
All night, Natalie. Mind over matter.
$1 million on the line. This is all you.
Laser focus, baby.
These two are so damn stubborn that even standing next to each other this close, they still have nothing to say to each other. It's a crazy relationship. I don't know what they have, but keeps things entertaining.
Guys, it's been over 4 hours. You guys are completely killing it. We'll be here all night long. I love it.
Natalie and I are just standing here suffering in silence. I'm just trying to not be in this moment. I'm trying to do anything and everything that I can to ignore this pain. My entire back is essentially in one big cramp.
It's been 5 hours, guys. 5 hours.
I just keep thinking about my past, my present, and where I want to be in my future. And I'm letting everything motivate me. I'm not letting my arms drop no matter what.
5.5 hours. You guys are setting records. But I'm going to need you both to turn around. That'll tighten up your slack and make it even more difficult. Good job.
I think everyone underestimated the stubbornness of Natalie and myself. And essentially what this has now become is a battle of wills between me and her. I see the look in his eyes. I see the look in Tony's eyes. They know that. Just fall, you mother. Fall, fall. Fall, fall. Oh, this bucket that just got dumped on my head is essentially my entire challenge season being dumped on my head. It's just that moment of realization where it's over, you know, and you realize it's over, and it was just a culmination.
All right, Natalie and Paulie, you guys went to the final.
Disbelief, Natalie and I just pulled off the hugest win of the season so far. I am officially in the final as a rookie. That's a huge accomplishment. Only other thing left to do is win this bitch.
find yourself in the last elimination, I ran into an immovable Venezuelan object. Only human being I've ever met that's as stubborn as I am, and I had to stand next to her for 5 hours.
I have no worse back spasms I've ever had in my entire life, dude. I literally can't stand up.
We came in here vendettas, and we had a bad past and stuff like that, and the that we've been through together, like, I'm happy to call this man my friend again.
I'm sorry, man.
No, don't be, dude. Don't be. You gave it everything you got.
All right, everybody, welcome to the final duel. Tonight, we're gonna have a male and a female duel. So first up is the guys, so I need CT and Brad. Come on in.
Come on, guys.
Come on, Brad.
You're on this side over here, Brad. All right, CT, Brad, you guys tonight, you're gonna be playing Push Me. As you guys seen this game before, when I say go, you guys are gonna push that pole as hard as you can, trying to retrieve that flag in the middle. When you reach that flag, you're gonna unhook the carabiner, get disqualified if you rip the flag off. So unhook the carabiner. Whoever does this without ripping the flag will win tonight's duel. Stay in the game and receive this T-Mobile Sidekick 3. But more importantly, you're gonna be staying in the game, going straight to the finals for 150 Gs. Let's just get this done. Both of you guys are great competitors. It's been a pleasure, for sure, no matter what happens. All right, so good luck, guys. Let's go.
I mean, this is as ready as you can possibly be for something like this. I'm gonna give it everything I have, absolutely everything I have, and that's all you can do.
This pole is my whole focus right now. It's a bone rack. It's got no legs. That's why I pick Push Me. I got more stamina, I'm bigger, I'm stronger. It's just a matter of time before he quits.
All right, guys, get ready, get set, go!
CT's freaking out, screaming, oh, you're burnt, done. And I'm just sitting there getting pissed, and I just start shaking the pipe as hard as I can because all I can do is defend him from the carabiner at this point.
You're done! Give me that! Get
it!
Oh,
you knifed it! I got it!
Oh.
Dude, you had
it. I had it. Come on, dude. I didn't rip it off. It's still on here.
You ripped it off.
I see it as clear as day. CT reaches down, grabs the flag and the carabiner, and instead of unhooking the carabiner, rips the flag out of the ground.
Oh, my God. You gotta be kidding me, dude. That's bull. You know it's bull. You can't stop me. That's the only way you're gonna beat me. That's bull. That's not a win. I'm the best kid here. All you know it. You love being free and square, you should just go home, bro.
I didn't make that call. And that's in the rules. Why are you yelling at me right now?
CT is literally stomping around like a little kid who is not giving a sucker at lunchtime.
It's like you wanted him to win.
He's a lowlife and needs to be kicked off this thing.
It's a weak wing, man. You know it's weak tape.
Bro, I said go for the carabiner only.
I went for the carabiner. All right. Put my hand on the carabiner.
You went for it, but it didn't work out for you, bro. Handle it.
Give it a ball. It's enough.
Shut him in the dog. What are you gonna do? What? You're a little punk.
No beam shot.
Throw up. Shut the f up. You know you're going hard. Shut the f.
This is where it's game time, you know? I've dominated the regular season. This is the playoffs, and I got the championship right in front of me. I'm the best competitor here. Everybody else needs to be worried about how fast I do this.
All right, Paul, you ready?
Go, baby!
Yeah!
Oh! Wow.
I dove in head first. Style points, maybe. Smart decision, definitely not.
Yeah, baby, come on! You're there! This is it, just climb as fast as you can, baby! Fast as you can, get up!
Man up!
Didn't know that was a factor.
Okay, now we know it's a weird net.
No hesitation, baby, you got it!
Yeah.
Pauly just showed how not to swing across that rope today.
Go, baby, it's okay, get up!
I hit the water hard, I'm freezing. I can't feel my body. My forearms aren't working right now.
Go, Pauly! Pull yourself back up for it! You want that final, that's what you came for. Put that foot up!
Pauly,
one foot up, it's those feet. Stand up,
I'm doing.
Keep pushing. If it's hard for you, it's gonna be hard for everybody.
It's just tough to watch because he's starting to freeze down there and he's obviously in pain. It is not the way that you want to see something like this start out.
You got this, Polly. You got it. You've got to keep going. You're going for $750,000.
My biggest concern is what's going on in Polly's head. And I'm worried that because he missed it two times, he might be freaking himself out. And all I can do is cheer him from the sides and just say, Polly, you have this. You have to keep going.
All right, Polly, you got 10 minutes. You got 10 minutes to finish, bro. Don't quit. You can do it.
Hold with your hands. Stand the f*** up on those legs. You're strong.
Keep
breathing.
Like this. Like this. Perfect.
At this point, my body's frozen, my fingers are numb, my feet are numb, but maybe if I can get this ring across, I still got a shot at this.
You can't do it. Now you have to fight.
Run, baby, this is it. Run.
Here we go.
Last time.
Maybe this challenge is harder than we all initially expected because the dude is a pretty fierce competitor. And if he looks that bad doing it, then I don't know. I don't know.
Grab onto that rope like you're grabbing onto the money. Those toes with everything you got. Those toes.
Go like this. Go, go.
Yeah.
Everything you got. The last one.
I think I have a grip, and my body just seizing up from shaking from how cold I am. I'm seeing my perfect season fall through my fingertips, literally.
Right up there.
You did it. Everything you got on the last one. Are you done?
Finish it out, babe. You're almost there.
To see a fall like that. And it's just killing me that there's nothing I can do to help him.
Moments of my life. The only thing that is keeping me from staying in that water is my own will and desire and pride.
All right, Polly, 2 more minutes, get it done.
He's screaming in pain, and to watch a man who's so strong and such a fierce competitor look so helpless is awful for everyone here.
Scream through it, Polly.
Yeah.
That's it. Time's up.
I love you, babe. You never quit. You're all heart.
Like, part of me is happy because now we just gotta go slow and get it done. But part of me is like,
it's terrible to watch.
Terrible to watch. We originally thought that this was gonna come down to seconds as to who is going to lose. And now it changes the entire dynamic of what the rest of the guys have to do, which is essentially just complete it and Polly goes home.
Oh, baby. I mean this.
All I needed was for one more person to fall. Dude, it's bad.
You're gonna have this chance again and nobody's gonna beat you.
After everything we've been through all season, I should have rushed it. F*** that up so bad.
big upset. You couldn't get it done. This ends your time here on the challenge, my friend.
Good luck, everyone.
Thank you so much for everything.
I've eliminated all my enemies. I protected my girlfriend. I made it here. The $750,000 is right there. I tasted it. I tasted it. All I had to do was make it to the final. And I failed.
Been through four gauntlets already. You've gone 4-0, and now I'm going in another final men's gauntlet against Timmy, and I'm praying that I don't lose.
All right, veterans, it comes down to this. Are you guys ready? Go!
Go, country!
Timmy, you're the new team captain. Congratulations. Good job today. Derek, there's no words.
Good job,
Timmy. Way to go,
Timmy.
You went out like a champion and a captain and on your own terms. So that's it. You got 20 minutes to get your stuff, and you're a champion, man. Good job. Good try. Welcome, everybody, to the final duel. Now, as we all know, Landon and Diem, they're in the duel no matter what. So we need to find out who they're going to be challenging in the duel. We'll start off with Landon. Who do you want to take in the duel with you?
Brad.
All right, Brad, come on down. Today, you're playing back off. Again, each player is going to start inside this circle with a hook attached to your back. There's also a ring suspended behind each player. Your goal is to retrieve that hook and attach it to their ring. First player to do this twice wins today's duel. Receive this Kicker IK500 MP3 docking station. But more importantly, whoever wins today's duel is automatically getting paid. Loser goes home empty-handed. You guys came too far to let that happen. All right?
I am so wound up right now. I can't stand myself. We got a lot of adrenaline going through me right now. It's like today's duel is for $100,000.
Come on, boys! Fire duel!
I'm planning on putting everything I have into this. My fiance went home, and I'm trying to win this money for us, and I'm trying to win this challenge for myself, so I'm getting it done.
All right, Landon, you ready?
Yeah.
Brad, you ready? Go!
Get it! Go in the circle!
I end up grabbing his hook.
Landon!
And as I'm going to put it on my ring, he's going for my body.
Landon, you got his ring. You gotta go.
Landon's not supposed to be tackling me at this point. That's not the game today.
That's bull. Gotta go for his ring, bro. You gotta hook it to the ring, dude.
That's mine.
Yeah, you don't know the rules of the game?
TJ said before, once you have the hook, you must go for your ring. Obviously, it's not a wrestling match. You get the hook, you put on the other person's ring, period.
All right, Brad, you have 1 point. One more, you're in the finals. Landon, you need this one to stay in the game. Landon, you ready?
Yeah.
Brad, you ready? Go! Get back in the circle. Get in the circle. Get in the circle, boys. You gotta go after the hook. Get in the circle, boys. Get in the circle.
Go, boys. Come on! Right now! Let's go!
All right, so Brad, you have 1 point. Landon, you have 1 point. Whoever gets this point wins the duel, goes to the finals.
It's all coming down to 1 point. We're both fired up going into this, knowing that this is for everything.
Landon, you ready?
Yeah.
Brad, you ready? Go!
Don't you dare!
Go for the hook! Go for the ring! Go for the ring! Go for the ring, Brad! Brad!
Oh, he got it!
He got it! Brad won.
I got it!
Brad pulls out this tricky little move that he just knocks Landon's ring and kind of goes flying all over the place. He gets a little discombobulated and loses.
I should have been able to clip that on there. And
That's the hardest part of this, is knowing that the game is in your hands. It's not easy. It sucks. It really, really, really sucks.
All right, Brad, well, they're not going to give it to you for free. You got some war wounds, man. Go ahead, rejoin the group. You're in the finals. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Great
so
job.
Much.
I'm going to be real honest. Part of me's feeling bad for Landon. At the same time, it's a game that we play. Not only am I guaranteed $15,000, but I have a much better shot at $100,000.
All right, Landon, unfortunately, this ends your time here in New Zealand, but there's never been a classier player on the duel, so good job, man, for that. So everybody, go ahead and say your goodbyes to Landon.
I think the hardest thing for me right now is the fact that I felt like I was the best one here. After winning, you know, more than half of the challenges, I felt like I deserved to be in the finals. And I blew it. But when I look back on what I got here, there is really nothing better. Because if I would have been at home, I would never have gotten this experience. And for that, I'm grateful.